'tis your faithfulness, O God. You wrestle with the sinner's restless heart. You lead us by still waters into mercy, and nothing can keep us apart. So
Let us join our voices and our hearts together as we praise God by praying. Glory to God in Christ, and on earth peace to the people of the world. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks to your great glory. Lord God,
a reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. In those days, the princes said to the king, Jeremiah ought to be put to death. He is demoralizing the soldiers who are left in this city and all the people by speaking such things to them. He is not interested in the welfare of our people, but in their ruin. King Zedekiah answered, he is in your power, for the king could do nothing with them. And so they took Jeremiah and threw him in the cistern of Prince Malachi, which was in the quarters of the guard, letting him down with ropes. There was no water in the cistern, only mud, and Jeremiah sank in the mud. Ebed-Melech, a court official, went there from the palace and said to him, my lord, these men have been at fault in all they have done to the prophet Jeremiah, casting him into the cistern. He will die of famine on the spot, for there is no more food in the city. Then the king ordered Ebed-Melech, the Cushite, to take three men along with him and draw the prophet Jeremiah out of the cistern before he should die. The word of the Lord.
Back,
Lord.
reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us rid ourselves of every burden and sin that clings to us, and persevere in running the race that lies before us, while keeping your eyes fixed on Jesus, the leader and perfecter of faith. For sake of the joy that lay before him, he endured the cross, despising its shame, and has taken a seat at the right hand of the throne of God. Consider how he endured such opposition from sinners, in order that you may not grow weary and lose heart. In your struggle against sin, you have not yet resisted to the point of shedding blood. The word of the Lord.
Says the Lord, I know them and they follow me. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, I have come to set the earth on fire, and how I wish it were already blazing. There is a baptism which I must be baptized, and how great is my anguish until it is accomplished. Do you think that I have come to establish peace on the earth? No, I tell you, but rather division. From now on, a household of five will be divided, three against two and two against three. A father will be divided against his son against his father, a mother against her daughter, and a daughter against her mother, a mother-in-law against her daughter-in-law, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. Rejoice, for this is good news, the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, it seems in that gospel the only thing that's left out is the son-in-law against his mother-in-law. Tells me that he Jesus doesn't want to mess around with mother-in-law. Well, as you know, in the bulletin the last few weeks, we've been sharing with you sad news.
it's not just to put a check mark on God's attendance card someplace, but that you come to Mass out of the love of God. You want to hear something that is connected to the Bible that you can take home to your family, to your workplace. And priests can tell that when people are here because they want to hear out of love of God and not because they're just checking off the box. So that was part of my challenge this morning at 8:02. I thought to myself, geez, that means I'm a priest this morning and I wasn't supposed to be, which means I didn't prepare anything to say. But being a priest, I always have something to say. Put. How am I trying to let that truth
healthy worry with regards to, am I bringing my gifts and talents in the best way, in the godly way, in a way that would make God smile and not blush? I heard an old priest, no comments. He thought, I could hear you, David. So, I heard an old priest a few weeks ago give a homily, and I hated an old priest to do this. But, I would say, in my humble opinion, he wasn't a really good speaker. But here's the part I hate. Some of these guys, they're not really great speakers, but they say incredible pieces of wisdom. And this is the piece that he said a few weeks ago when I was there celebrating priests. This old priest said, in a few moments, you're going to receive Holy Communion, Jesus. Jesus is going to be right with you inside you. Remember, that becomes a part of your blood, becomes a part of your body. Jesus is with you. Never take Jesus any place that you can be embarrassed. Never look upon anything that would cause Jesus to blush. Never say anything that would cause Jesus to wince. I remember that several weeks ago. But see, this is the truth of it. That you and I have unique gifts, talents, and abilities, and where our worry should be is, am I using those so that I'm making my difference in the world that would never make God wince, that would never make God blush, that the decisions that I'm advocating in my family, in my workplace, in my neighborhood, with my friends, that they're never decisions that would cause Jesus to blush and embarrass him. Panic is when we don't believe anything. When we think that God doesn't care about us intimately every single moment, that God isn't going to be able to take us through whatever happens to us. And so we look upon our gifts and our talents not as ways to give, as God gives to us, but as ways to take. We panic. We have to take care of ourselves. Jeremiah the prophet didn't do that. So many of the people of the Old Testament didn't do that. And here's the clincher. Jeremiah was stopped in the mud, it said in the first reading. He trusted that God was going to get him out of that. And God sent people to have it happen. The people of the Old Testament were in slavery, starving in the desert, heat. They had hope. They had faith that God would feed them, and manna fell from heaven. The clincher is that it wasn't until Jeremiah trusted that God could get him out of the mud. It wasn't until the people in slavery had faith that God could free them. So you and I actually hold the key in our lives to whatever wants to take life from us, whatever wants to bind us, to take us from God, to keep us not on the side of forgiveness, but on the side of bitterness, not on the side of love, but on the side of hate, not on the side of hope, but on the side of despair. You and I have the key. And they have the key of trust and the key of faith. But like any block, you first have to live in the key before it can be opened. For God's power in our life to happen, to free us, we first have to trust. And then he can lift us up. We first have to have faith. Then he can give us what we need. May that be a gift we give to God and therefore to ourselves, not only today, but for the rest of our lives.
Let's stand now together and...
profess the faith that gathers us as one. I believe in one God, the Father, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of God before all ages, God of God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, consubstantial with the Father, through whom all things were made, for our sin and for our salvation. Offer now to the Lord some of the needs that gather us here this morning.
For Pope Francis and all the leaders of our church, as they seek to light the fire in the world with the good news of God's merciful love, let us pray to the Lord. For peace among our nations rather than division and strife, let us pray to the Lord. For young people and all those preparing to return to school, that they may be faithful to the truth that they will learn, let us pray to the Lord. For those who suffer with or are burdened by the heat on these long summer days, let us pray to the Lord. For those on the margins of our society, that they not grow weary and lose heart, but instead know God's gracious and abundant mercy and love during this Jubilee year of mercy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Gracious and loving God, we ask you to listen to the prayers which we have voiced, but as always, to the silent longings of our hearts. And if they be for your greater honor, for our greater good, that you grant them all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And please join in singing our song of preparation. It's in your blue praise and worship music books. In the blue books, it is number 48, We Fall Down.
Cry, holy, holy, holy.
receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks and praise, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from an ending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we proclaim your glory, as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Have mercy on us all, we pray,
that together with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her faithful spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who are pleased to do your will throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Thank you.
Christ in me, arise and dispel all the darkness. Christ in me, arise with your power and your strength. Christ in me, pour out your blessing and healing. Christ in me, arise, and I shall rise with you. Be now my vision, open these eyes, showing me all that I must see. Onward to the kingdom, you are the way. Arise in me and I shall rise with you. Christ in me, arise and dispel all the darkness. Christ in me, arise with your power and your strength. Christ in me, pour out your blessing and healing. Christ in me, arise, and I shall rise with you. When the storms of life are raging, Lord, stand by me. When the currents pulls me under, Lord, stand by me. When the rising waters toss me like a ship upon the sea, you who rule the wind and water, Lord, stand by me. Stand by me. Tyrant wields his terror, and the armies wage their might. When the darkness overwhelms me, Lord, stand by. Stand by me, lift me up from the restless sea. When I am lost, when love can't be found, when no one cares, Lord, stand by me, stand by me. Stand by me.
Well, this is the moment at our weekend masses when we like to have a chance to welcome folks who are with us for the first time. And we officially do that. I would like that beautiful baby. Could you bring your beautiful baby up so that we can see it? It's just beautiful. Come on. It's this beautiful 2-month-old baby. The fact that the baby's suffering, my mom would not take that.
When was there
humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed to his image on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go now to live it in peace and in joy.
Thanks be to God.
Have a great week, everybody.
You too, Father. Please join in singing our recessional hymn in your missalettes, number 161, Alleluia, Love is Alive.
People of God, see the morning is new. Rise from your sleeping and run to the tomb. Come and see, come and see, he is alive. Grave that is empty, a promise fulfilled. God who was with us is here with us still. He is here, he is here, he is alive. Alleluia, love is alive. Conquered the grave and defeated the night. Alleluia, love is alive. The sun has arisen for all. Alleluia, love is alive. Conquer the grave and defeat in the night. Alleluia, love is alive. The sun has arisen for all.